According to Martin Yalimo, the Refugee Welfare Council 1 chairperson for Village 7, the highly explosive device was discovered on Saturday morning by a one Samuel Modi.
We did not sleep the whole of the night. Why are we not sleeping? It's because we have something which is very dangerous in our middle. And since the neighboring people near to this place where this bomb was placed, each and everyone is now thinking of how he or she is going to survive.
Modi, the family head of 9, described the incident as unfortunate to him and his family. He says he has been under the threat by unknown people. He claimed that he has been reporting every development to the leaders and the Office of the Prime Minister, United Nations High Commissioner for Refugees and International Rescue Committee. Aswab Anule Juma, the vice chairperson for Kalulu sub-county, also condemned the action of threats on people's lives. He said such threats don't only cause panic to the family of the targeted person, but also the community within.
It hurts me so much. It's not a good happening that such an incident is could happen in my parish and at my sub-county at large. With that, I would like to request the government to at least look into it that the security of my people should be taken to consideration.
John Bosco Tumwesije, the resident district commissioner Yumbe, confirmed the incident. He said the security team visited the scene, examined the situation, and cordoned off the home.
In the refugee settlements, someone ties a doctor's grenade on the door. The good news, there were no people inside. But I'm appealing to the public to be vigilant and security conscious. And should it touch or tamper with anything they don't know.
Today, experts from UPDF Division Headquarters in Gulu arrived in Yumbe and detonated the device successfully.
69 Battalion Headquarters, we got there two mortar millimeter bomb and one hand grenade. We came with it together here. The one we found in this camp was one hand grenade also. So we compiled together. We have demolished it here. The operation went successful.
Martin Yalimo, RWC 1 chairperson for Village 7, lauded the team of security for the tireless efforts to ensure the highly explosive device is removed.
The whole yesterday we were together with the police. We stayed here the whole night and during the daytime, and we start getting how possible this thing can be taken. So by the time when these people reached, when they figured this thing out from the house, I was very happy, and from that time I've already said, they have already saved all our lives.
Report by Adam Gule for the news.